You look rather pleasant this morning. What a nice place to be. It is going to be fine. That morning cloud should waft on away, and there's a northeasterly wind, but it's not overly warm, about 18 degrees today.
What morning cloud? There wasn't any morning cloud there.
It's wafted off.
Well, you said it should waft off. It clearly already has wafted off.
It might be still wafting in other places.
Yeah, all right. Golden Horse have fast become the darlings of the New Zealand pop rock scene. See how smoothly I ran into something completely different. The band's first album, Riverhead, was slow to hit a groove, as they say, but it's become a timeless hit with the young and old, judging by the number of albums they've sold. In fact, just over 50,000, which for New Zealand album sales is stunning. But as Renee Mundy found out on the eve of their second album launch, Golden Horse would rather be defined by their music than their audience.
Who do you think your audience is, and what? What do you think that they are going to think about your album?
You don't want to say who's going to go out there and buy it, because
might be wrong.
It might be wrong. And you might be limiting your audience, and there's no way on earth that I want to limit my audience.
I reckon it'll be the same people as last time and a whole lot more other people. Yeah,
and they'll really like it.
Really like it.
Matured personally, and I suppose that reflects in the band. Yep.
And I think we are more of a band now than we were with Riverhead. Riverhead, we hadn't been together that long when we started making the record, and all that attention went into making a record. And since then, it's been touring and rehearsing as a band. So it's a more sort of as a band, I think we've matured. Yeah.
Second album, was it difficult for you? Did you find that you were striving to match Riverhead?
I think we were striving to beat Riverhead, and I think we have.
You think you have? Why is that?
I just feel better about it. I like this record better. Hey, maybe in 6 months I won't, but I'm pretty sure right now it's real good. Yeah, we've got a new rhythm section, Vince and Ben. Plays in the old one, and that's changed the band too, of course, you know. It feels different, sounds different.
Yeah, it's more productive. We haven't got any, we haven't got people being bankers during the day or, you know, that kind of thing, not that we did before, but everyone's into what we're doing, so that can be a really divisive thing in a band, to have people going off doing their day jobs. You can't keep productive when there's sort of split emphasis in your life.
Hmm. Do any of you ever have a creative crisis, ever?
All the time.
Yeah.
Just one big continual crisis.
That's what being creative is. Yeah, it's just moving from one crisis to the next.
We cook a lot. Me and Ben cook a lot. Yeah. I think that for me, that's my like chill out thing. Yeah. Is I just go and do some crazy new recipe, and that's my sort of relaxation, creative thing.
Yeah. Jeff doesn't get it out of the system. So yeah. He just doesn't sleep.
It's like a washing machine constantly spin.
You don't want to know what I do with your life.
Go out and buy it and enjoy it.
Yeah. And
play it.
And have it be.
Don't buy it and put it on your shelf. Don't do that. Buy it and play it. Yeah. Yeah.
Some good advice there from Golden Horse.
And the new album from Golden Horse is called Out of the Moon.
Don't buy it and put it in a jar, like people do with their 5-cent coins. Incidentally, very quickly, Peter, one of the esteemed crew here, has worked out that the $89.35 that someone had saved in 5-cent pieces is actually almost 1,800 5-cent pieces.
Big jar.